This is Pete Murray welcoming you to the Eurovision Song Contest 1977. As the orchestra play the overture, we'll take an aerial glimpse of the United Kingdom. Big Ben showing the time of just after 9 o'clock. How come it's daylight? Well, that's another BBC miracle. Big Ben was named after Sir Benjamin Hall, Commissioner of Works, when the bell was first hung. The Houses of Parliament, also known as the Palace of Westminster, with the House of Lords containing just over 1,000 members. The House of Commons, give or take a by-election or two, approximately 635 members. This is a view of the Fourth Bridge, one of the longest suspension bridges in the world, 8,244 feet in total length, with a central span of 3,500 feet. Edinburgh Castle now, with the main shopping area, Princes Street, in the background, one of the most beautiful cities in the world, famed now for its festival. This is Carnarvon Castle, beautiful castle, medieval castle, built in 1528 for a cost of £12,000. By today's value, the cost would have been something nearer £2 million. This is a view of the Causeway Coast in County Armagh in Northern Ireland. It consists of about 40,000 solidified lava columns packed together. A very beautiful tourist place with a 10-mile walk along the top of the headland. Now we're nearing home base, Wembley Stadium, the scene of today's Rugby League Cup final. Congratulations to Leeds on winning the cup, by the way. And here, the Wembley Conference Centre, which of course is the scene for this year's show. The Eurovision Song Contest 1977. Angela Rippon.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. On behalf of the British Broadcasting Corporation, it's my very great pleasure to welcome the hundreds of millions of viewers and listeners in 33 countries throughout the world who've joined us this evening for this really exciting musical occasion. Here in the concert hall of the Wembley Conference Centre in London, 18 countries are about to compete for the Grand Prix of the Eurovision Song Contest for 1977. For each of the songs, the BBC Television Orchestra will be under the musical direction of a conductor chosen by the participating country. The songs themselves will be sung in an order already established as the result of a draw, which took place in Geneva under the auspices of the European Broadcasting Union. I would now like, on your behalf, to wish all the artists who will be taking part this evening, and indeed those people who will be judging them, the very best of luck with this contest. Mesdames,
and as Angela reports in French what she just said in English, may I tell you something about the Wembley Conference Centre? It was officially opened by the Duke of Kent on the 31st of January this year and is London's first purpose-built conference and convention centre and is located at Wembley Stadium. The concert hall in which the Eurovision Song Contest is being staged tonight is one of the most modern in Europe and has a seating capacity for something like 2,500 people. Well, it's certainly a full house tonight, and first to go to night are Ireland, and representing them are the Swarbricks Plus Two. The boys Tommy and Jimmy took part in the contest in 1975 in Stockholm, taking sixth place on that occasion. This year they've been joined by two delicious colleagues, Alma Karen, who recently appeared with Bing Crosby on American television, and Nicola Kerr, also a very successful singer in her own right. The song, it's called It's Nice to Be in Love Again, strongly fancied by the betting fraternity, and written by Tommy and Jimmy themselves. Now back to Angela.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to London. Welcome to the Eurovision Song Contest for 1977. And an especially warm welcome to the very first of those 18 competitors. Ladies and gentlemen, the song from Ireland.
The Irish musical director has appeared on several occasions on the Eurovision Song Contest. His name, Noel Keelahan. Song, It's Nice to Be in Love Again by the Swarbricks Plus Two. Now, if you'd like to keep a check on the songs, There's a special panel on Saturday's TV page of the Radio Times. Well, now it's Monaco. Song number two on the list. The song is called La Petite Française, the little French girl, written by three Frenchmen, Jean Albertini, Paul de Saint-Ville, and Paul Toussaint. The singer is Michèle Thor, and she's also French, and a protégé of the late Maurice Chevalier. And she's certainly going to do him proud tonight, I promise you. And the musical director, who has worked with such people as Charles Aznavour, Michel Legrand, Mireille Mathieu, and Gilbert Beco, this is him, Yvan Riolan.
Je ne suis pas Marilyn, je n'aime pas la nuit, et dans les magazines, je ne lis pas ma vie. Je suis une provinciale, je n'ai pas lu Pascal, j'ai une vie normale, c'est presque original. Et sans avoir de Rolls, il n'y a pas mieux, je crois. Quand je vois quelques gosses qui jouent autour de moi.
Petite Française, sung by Michèle Thor for Monaco. Now it's the Netherlands who take the stand, and they've had an amazing track record, having lifted the trophy no less than four times. The last time being in Stockholm in 1975, with Ding, Ding-a-Dong. Well, nepotism is running riot this year because Hedy Lester is the singer, and her brother, Frank Afalter, wrote the song. The song's called De Malemolen, the lyric of which was penned by one Vin Hogenkamp. It's a 9-1 bet, this one, as far as the bookmakers are concerned. And it's time now to meet the musical director for the Netherlands, a man who's been carrying the baton for his country for some 7 years now, Harry van Holt. Thank you.
weg een rondje mee. De molen draait ook zonder jou, je paard blijft nooit lang leeg. Dus kom, draai met die malenmolen mee. Bij de malenmolen van het leven staat iedereen te wachten in een rij. Wachten tot je mee mag doen, het duurt misschien wel even, maar voor iedereen is er een paardje bij. In de malenmolen van het leven draai je allemaal je eigen rondje mee. De molen draait ook zonder jou, je paard blijft nooit lang leef. Dus kom, draai met die malenmolen mee.
Eenmaal in de molen van het leven, in het begin ben je misschien bang. Dan zal iemand je vasthouden totdat je net alleen kunt, want de malenmolen angst duurt nooit te lang.
In de malenmolen van het leven draai je allemaal je eigen rondje mee. De molen draait op zonder jou, je paard blijft nooit lang leeg. Dus kom, draai met die malenmolen mee.
En die mensen nevens malenmolen ga door dat je er draaierig van bent. Maar jij blijft je toch vasthouden, al vind je het niet leuk meer, want naast de molen is het onbekend.
In de malenmolen van het leven draai je allemaal je eigen rondje mee. De molen draait op zonder jou, je paard blijft nooit lang leeg. Dus kom, draai met die malenmolen mee. In de malenmolen van het leven draai je allemaal je eigen rondje mee. De molen draait op zonder jou, je paard blijft nooit lang leeg. Dus kom, draai met die malenmolen mee. Dus kom, draai met die malenmolen mee.
Well, that's a 9-1 shot, according to the bookmakers. De Malenmolen, The World Keeps Turning, the song from the Netherlands, sung by Hedy Lester. Well, now for Austria. Well, we've been warned that anything could happen from this group, Schmetterlinger, and they've had quite a bit of publicity through their political outbursts during performances. They recently presented a 3.5-hour work illustrating the oppression of the working classes. And I'll truthfully say that there are real bundle of fun, this lot. Their song, Boom Boom Boomerang, is about the exploitation of artists and groups in the recording world. The group wrote themselves on souls, but make no mistake about it, they're good and they're very professional. And they call themselves Schmetterlinger. And they'll be performing in just a few seconds from now. The musical director is Christian Kolonowitz.
Music is love for you and me. Music is money for the record company.
Musik liegt wieder in der Luft. Das ist der ganz besondere Duft der großen Welt, die uns gefällt.
DJ vor dem Mikrofon,
leg uns jetzt auf den Plattenteller.
Den Schlager der Saison,
Moneten bringt der Superseller.
Mono oder Stereo, live oder im Studio.
bis Luzern.
Und der Dollar rockt und rollt.
Mono oder Stereo, live oder im Studio, Album oder Single. Klinge, Kasse, Klinge. Rhythm and Blues, Rock and Roll, Reggae, Shuffle oder Soul. Clap your hands, stamp your feet, copy diesen Superhit.
Only the demonstration of the audience, not from Schmetterlinger. They've just sung for Austria, Boom Boom Boomerang. Now on to song number 5. And Norway's the country, and year after year they've stoically entered the contest and never won. This year they're pinning their hopes on a song called Casanova, which really needs no translation. We all know what he got up to. Music by Svein Stostad, the lyricist Dag Newtormer, the singer Anita Skorgen, who was born 19 years ago. That's 3 years after the first Eurovision Song Contest. Anita is an outstanding pianist and athletically is adept at throwing the discus. The musical director, well, that's the fourth occasion for him. He is Kostan Hallman. The Norwegian song Casanova, sung by Anita Skorgen. Well, if you are checking on that Radio Times Eurovision chart, you'll know that Germany are singing song number 6. And on the bookmaker chart, they're a 5-1 bet. This, however, is an international setup. The lyricist, Michael Kunz, was born in Prague, Czechoslovakia. The composer, Sylvester Live, is a Hungarian, born in Yugoslavia. And the group, Silver Convention, consists of a German and two Americans. And to cap it all, as you'll see in a minute, they have an English musical director. Somebody that you all know very well, certainly by name. That stalwart of the Generation Game. By name, of course, Ronnie Hazelhurst. The song is called Telegram and is certainly fancied at 5-1. Well, that's a 5-1 shot, and the most applause so far this evening at the Wembley Conference Centre. Telegram, the title of that German song, the group Silver Convention. Oh, now for the small country with a big musical heart, Luxembourg. A country the size of Surrey with a population of some 300,000 people, and amazingly, the winners of this trophy no less than 4 times. The song is called Frère Jacques, written by two Frenchmen, Pierre Court and Guy Béard. Pierre Coeur wrote Tant pis les billets, a previous winning song for France. He also wrote Love is Blue, which was an unsuccessful Eurovision song, but eventually went on to number one all over the world and sold something like 6 million records for Paul Mauriard. Singing for Luxembourg is film actress Anne-Marie Bay. The musical director is another Briton who's conducted in previous Eurovision Song Contest for Mary Hopkin and Hurdy Clodagh Rodgers, and his name is Johnny Arfi. Was Anne-Marie Bay singing Frère Jacques for Luxembourg. Well, now to Portugal, which to most Britons means sunny days on the Algarve beaches. The song is called Portugal no Coração, the English title, Portugal in My Heart. And you'll realize that this is no ordinary Eurovision song when I translate the first stanza. Portugal is the reason my brother died, and it's also the beat in my heart, a song of the revolution. Ari dos Santos is a lyricist who's written for Portugal in 69, 71 and 73 and is considered to be a leading revolutionary poet. He combined in the 73 song with this year's composer Fernando Toro. The group, Os Amigos, are all set now, and one expects almost that the musical director, José Capelario, is going to conduct with a rifle for the Dundee.
Portugal foi a razão porque um dia morreu meu irmão. Mas também é coração a bater nesta canção.
Não sei bem de quem eu nasci, não descobri nem pai nem mãe. Só sei que já nasci aqui e foi aqui que eu fui alguém.
Well, that was the Portuguese song Portugal No Coração by Os Amigos. The United Kingdom entry now, which as we all know, or should know by now anyway, is Rock Bottom, which Lindsay DePaul and Mike Moran wrote over a dinner table, would you believe? And there's really no answer to that. Lindsay's original intention was to be a concert pianist, but her success in pop has brought her two Ivor Novello Awards, a nomination for Top Female Performer, and the Variety Club's Women of the Year title. Mike Moran, an established member of the Blue Mink, has played piano for Shirley Bassey, Johnny Mathis, Stevie Wonder, Charles Aznavour, and Dusty Springfield. We, of course, on your behalf, wish them every success tonight with the song Rock Bottom. And as we see, they're practically set now. They've had to move the grand pianos onto the stage, and they're all looking absolutely splendid, calm, cool and collected. And coming out of the trap, having previously conducted for Germany, is our city gent, Ronnie Hazelhurst. And here he comes.
Rock bottom, rub it out and start it again. sympathy.
Oh, I get it.
Harmony.
You said it.
Where are we?
Rock bottom.
Rub it out and start it again.
Good applause there for Lindsay DuPaul and Mike Moran singing the song they composed for the United Kingdom, Rock Bottom. That's quoted at 9-2. Well, now for Greece and a strongly fancied song, fancied that is, by the musicians, and much to their amazement, is quoted at 20-1. And they thought it was going to be quite a bit of competition for Mike and Lindsay. It's called Mathema Solfège, Musical Games. A 30-year-old woman wrote the lyric by name Sevi Tiliakou. The composer is also the musical director for Greece. His name is George Hatzinasiosis. And he doesn't sign autographs easily, believe me. The group are Pascalis, Bessie, Mariana and Robert. The last name, an Englishman with the surname of Williams, now living and working in Greece. In a moment, we'll be meeting the aforementioned composer, who is going to conduct for the Greek song, Mr. George Hatzinasiosis.
Sopa, sopa, mi dosi, mi, 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 dosi, dosi, dosi. δυο μελωδικές νότες στην καρδιά του είσαι. Κάνε την καρά τραγούδι και παντού πες το, και το σ' αγαπώ.
Maybe 20 to 1, but the audience here at the Wembley Conference Centre certainly gave it a very good ovation. Matheme Solfege, the Greek song sung by Pascalis, Bessie, Mariana and Robert. And now Israel with song number 11, To You, 10. The song is called Achava Hishilishnaim, and it's not surprising that I'm free for bar mitzvahs. The song in English is called Love is a Song for Two. The lyricist is Edna Pelesh, who this year won first prize in a Chilean song festival. Elda Shrem composed the song and is also considered to be Israel's top arranger and conductor. And he's not conducting tonight, however. The Israeli singer is Elanit, and the MD, the musical director, is Elda Shrem.
Yeah.
song for Israel, Achava Hishia Lishnaim, sung by Ilanit, quoted at 16 to 1, and Mazel Tov to them. The song for Switzerland, song number 12 on your list in the Radio Times chart, is Swiss Lady. Peter Reber, a man of many parts, wrote the words and the music and was to have conducted the orchestra, but for some reason or other he's not tonight. The artists, the Pepe Leinhaar Sextet, are a fun group with an unusual lineup. A gentleman named Mostafa uses an alpine horn to extremely good effect. Lovely sound. This is another song that's taken the fancy, this time of our technicians here at the Wembley Conference Centre. And the song is Swiss Lady. And we're about to meet the conductor now of the orchestra for Switzerland. Jacques Berlund is his name. And he's about to come out of trap number 3 in a minute.
Schlank und manchmal nahm er sie auf seinen Schrank. Dann machte er Musik und legte zärtlich die Hand um sie. Er spielte Rock'n'Roll, er spielte Dixieland und war bekannt als die One-Man-Mountain-Band. Er sagte, du sie allein ist die Welt voll Musik. Sie gibt mir alles und vergiss mich nie. Sie ist meine süße Lady und ich ein Mann aus den Bergen. Und wer sie einmal gehört hat, der kann mich sicher verstehen. Ja, sie ist meine Swiss Lady und ich ein Mann aus den Bergen. Und wer sie einmal gehört hat, weiß nur, ein Alphorn klingt so schön. Wenn er nach Hause kam, nahm er sie in den Arm, wo er sie liebevoll auseinander nahm. Doch vorher spielte er nochmal im Dixie-Stil. Und in der tiefen Nacht die Leute aufgewacht und haben sich beschwert. Dann hat er nur gelacht, er sagte, ich lade euch ein und wir feiern ein Fest, weil meine Lady noch nicht schlafen will. Sie ist meine Swiss Lady und ich ein Mann aus den Bergen. Und wer sie einmal gehört hat, der kann mich sicher verstehen. Ja, sie ist meine Swiss Lady und ich ein Mann aus den Bergen. Und wer sie einmal gehört hat, weiß nur, ein Alphorn klingt so schön. Ja. Sie ist meine Swiss Lady und ich ein Mann aus den Bergen. Und wer sie einmal gehört hat, der kann mich sicher verstehen. Sie ist meine Swiss Lady und ich ein Mann aus den Bergen. Und wer sie einmal gehört hat, weiß nur, ein Alphorn klingt so schön.
Well, that was Swiss Lady by the Pepe Leinhaar Sextet. And so we come to song 13, or to be fair to Sweden, who hold the spot, let's call it 12A. The song is called Beatles, and as you might imagine, is a tribute to that amazing group of the 60s, written by music publisher Sven Olaf Bagger, and featuring a group with the Scottish name of Forbes, although they call them Forbes in Sweden. The lead member is Peter Forbes, born in Stockholm, of a Scottish father. They certainly get around those Scots, don't they? They've had great success as a group, and without any doubt, they're hoping to emulate ABBA and win for Sweden again with their song Beatles, which, as I say, is song number 13 on your list. I think you'll find this a good one too, although, as far as I can make out, not fancied in the bookmakers' running. The Swedish musical director is Anders Berglund, and he's going to come out now, with any luck.
Yesterday var den var fin. Alla älskar melodin.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
När skivor kom då gick det larm. Grammofonen den i kvarn. Alla föll för Beatles barn.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a song called Beatles by Forbes, the Swedish song. That's 13 gone, 5 to come. And Spain is the next country to show their wares. Their song is called Ensamje a Cantar, which I'm told translate into English to Teach Me to Sing. A rather dangerous title on a night like this, I think. Spain have won the Eurovision Song Contest once outright and once in Madrid when they shared the title with three other countries. And what a night that was. And we sincerely hope that won't happen again. A lot of people are whistling this one around the corridors. Mickey is the singer, got a very pleasing style. He is accompanied by three girl singers, a very attractive, smiling, pretty girl on banjo. Both words and music were, or are in fact, by Fernando Arbex, who was going to conduct the orchestra tonight, but has handed over to the baton to a gentleman who is famed throughout Spain as an outstanding musical director, who goes by the name of Rafael Ibarra. Barbin. And Raphael Barbin is about to take the stand now. Insomnia al cantar by Mickey, the Spanish song. Song number 15 is for Italy, and although known as a land of song, amazingly Italy have only won the Eurovision Song Contest once, and that was back in 1964. The song for 1977 is Libera, which means freedom. However, there's no political connotation, I'm told. The lyric is by a man who has a stack of hits to his name, Luigi Albertini. The composer is Salvatore Fabrizio, and he's won the Venice Song Festival on a couple of occasions. The singer, Mia Martini, has also got an excellent track record in song festivals. She describes herself as something of a gypsy, changes her hairstyle every day to suit her mood. And we're wondering what sort of mood her hairstyle will denote this evening. Well, we have no idea, because we don't know what each hairstyle denotes anyway. So your guess is as good as mine. The musical director for Italy is the brother of the composer. His name is Maurizio Fabrizio.
Liberati parlare, sbagliar da me. So bene quel che voglio e quello che non voglio. Ho il mio orgoglio e cosa c'entri tu? Scopri mi innamorata, ma non ho quelle cose. Cosa abituata a camminare da sera.
He really sucked it to them there. That was Mia Martini singing Libera for Italy. Well, back we go to Scandinavia. This time it's the turn of Finland, song number 16, Laponia, which has the same title in English because it's a geographical location as much as anything else. It's a soulful, dramatic song, and if there were prizes for arrangements, then I reckon this song would get one. The Finns have never won this contest, and if they're ever going to, well, tonight is as good a chance as they've ever had. Winning a contest of this kind, of course, is so dependent on the mood of the jurors and the different tastes of those jurors. The composer is Arno Ranien, who's been writing songs since the age of 14. And the singer, Monica Aspeland, a big voice singer, gives it all she's got. The musical director for Finland, an old hand on Eurovision, Ossi Runna. That was Laponia, sung by Monica Aspelund for Finland. Now to Belgium and a song that's already had a great success in the hit parade of Europe. It's a 4-1 favourite, according to one well-known bookmaker. And if it does win, it'll be the first time for Belgium, first time they've ever won. It's called A Million in 1, 2, 3. The group, Dream Express, comprised the three Meissen sisters, that's Bianca, Patricia and Stella, with Luc Schmetz. That's a gentleman singing with the three girls. They're highly professional, highly successful, and recently had a personal triumph at London's Talk of the Town. Luc Schmetz, who appears with the three Meissen sisters as Dream Express, wrote the song himself. Incidentally, the song will be performed in English. The musical director is a talented arranger-composer, Englishman Alan Ainsworth. It's got the kind of applause we anticipated it would do. It is the 4-1 favourite. Dream Express, the name of the group, representing Belgium with A Million in 1, 2, 3. Well, last into bat, last but not least, are France, who've won this contest outright three times and once shared top position. The song is called L'Oiseau et l'Enfant, the bird and the child. You can't say this programme isn't educational. The co-writers are Jean-Paul Caca and Jo Grassi, both well known in their native country and indeed internationally. The singer Marie Myriam is Congolese born of French nationality, and like many of the artists on this show, has quite a good deal of experience in this type of contest. The song 16-1. That's shared with Israel, which is also 16-1. The French musical director is Raymond Donné.
Passer au loin les oiseaux, comme l'oiseau bleu survolant la terre, voit comme le monde est beau. Pour le bateau dansant sur les vagues, ivre de vie, d'amour et de vent, belle la chanson naissante des vagues, abandonnée au sable blanc, blanc l'innocent, le sang du poète. Qui en chantant invente l'amour pour que la vie s'habille de fête et que la nuit se change en jour, journée de vie où l'on se lève pour réveiller la ville aux yeux lourds, où les matins effeuillent les rêves pour nous donner un monde d'amour. Au loin les oiseaux, comme l'oiseau bleu survolant la terre, nous trouverons ce monde amour.
L'amour c'est toi, l'amour c'est moi, l'oiseau c'est toi, l'enfant c'est moi.
Miriam with the last song in the contest, song number 8. Miriam with the last song in the contest, song number 18 for France, L'Oiseau et l'Enfant.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've now heard all the songs from each of the 18 countries, which means that it's time for our judges around the world to start casting their votes. In each country, the judging panel consists of 11 people, and I know that at this moment, the jury chairman will be counting those votes. Now this year, the judging is going to take place in this way. The song that receives the maximum number of votes will be given 12 points. The song that comes second will be given 10, the third 8, and then 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1 for those songs that come fourth to 10th. And of course, no country is allowed to vote for itself. Mesdames, Mademoiselles, Messieurs,
and as Angela goes off into the Francais once again, I'd like to do a recap of the betting odds of this year's Eurovision Song Contest. Belgium are favourites with the bookies, 4-1, United Kingdom, 9-2, Germany 5-1, Ireland 6-1, Netherlands 9-1, Italy 14-1, France and Israel 16-1. I don't necessarily agree with those odds. Good outside bets, I think, are Greece, Spain and Switzerland. But musical tastes are different all over the world, and there are 18 juries, all with different ideas to contend with. But we'll soon know the result. After Angela has finished her French speech, she'll be introducing the cabaret for the evening. Let's hear her speak a little bit of French.
Jeudi dernier, à l'occasion d'une dîner dans un restaurant au centre de Londres, tous les chanteurs et musiciens ont pu se rencontrer et fait connaissance. Dans une atmosphère détendue, tous les artistes se souhaitent bonne chance. Last Thursday, we all went to a party at a restaurant here in the heart of London. It was an opportunity for the artists and musicians to meet and get to know one another, and of course to wish each other good luck for this evening's performance. It was also an opportunity for all of us to be entertained by a really great jazz musician. And this evening now to entertain you from that party, Mr. Ackerbilk and his Paramount Jazzmen. Mesdames, Mesdemoiselles, Messieurs, le Comte de Voix.
Angela is now explaining the voting procedure to the French-speaking audience. I'm sure most people know it, but then again, maybe they don't. The adjudicator of the Eurovision, and indeed European Broadcasting Union, is Clifford Brown. And this is Clifford's 11th year with the Eurovision Song Contest, and he loves every moment of it.
And in just a moment, I shall be going over to the individual countries, asking them for their decisions. Here in London, the votes will be verified by the official representative of the European Broadcasting Union, Mr. Clifford Brown. And I know that Clifford will be the one to stop me if we notice any error at all up there on that scoring board. But now we've come to the point at which I can say, maintenant le premier jury, votre vote, s'il vous plaît. And I think we go first of all to Ireland. Good evening, Dublin.
Good evening, Dee, Eve, Artie and Shatham Lark here. Good evening, Angela. This is Dublin. Here is the result of the Irish jury. Monaco, 5 points.
Monaco, 5 points. Monaco, 5 points.
Netherlands, 3 points.
Netherlands, 3 points. Les Pays-Bas, 3 points.
Germany, 1 point.
Germany, 1 point. Allemagne, 1 point.
Luxembourg, 2 points.
Luxembourg, 2 points. Luxembourg, 2 points.
Israel, 7 points.
Israel, 7 points. Israel, 7 points.
Switzerland, 6 points.
Switzerland, 6 points. La Suisse, 6 points.
Italy, 8 points.
Italy, 8 points. Italie, 8 points.
Finland, 12 points.
Finland, 12 points. Finland, 12 points. A round of applause for the first song.
Rightly so. Belgium, 4 points.
Belgium, 4 points. Belgique, 4 points.
France, 10 points.
France, 10 points. La France, 10 points.
That completes the vote of the Irish jury. Good night, Angela.
Good night, Dublin. Thank you very much indeed. Well, that's a good start. Now we're going to say bonsoir Monaco. Monaco, may we have your votes, please?
Bonsoir Wembley, ici Monaco. Voici les résultats du jury monégasque. Irlande, 8 points.
Irlande, 8 points. Ireland, 8 points.
Pays-Bas, 3 points.
Pays-Bas, 3 points. The Netherlands, 3 points.
Autriche, 5 points.
Autriche, 5 points. Austria, 5 points.
Allemagne, 1 point.
Allemagne, 1 point. Germany, 1 point.
Portugal, 2 points.
Portugal, 2 points. Portugal, 2 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Oh, that's patriotism. Royaume-Uni, 12 points. The United Kingdom, 12 points.
Good, we made it.
Grèce, 10 points.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
Greece.
Yes.
10 points.
Grèce, 10 points. Greece, 10 points.
Israel, 7 points.
Israel, 7 points. Israel, 7 points.
Italy, 6 points.
Italy, 6 points. Italy, 6 points.
France, 4 points.
France, 4 points. France, 10 points.
Ceci termine les points attribués par le jury monégasque. Bonsoir, Wembley.
Bonsoir, Monaco.
I'm sorry, there's been a misunderstanding there. France should read 14 points, please.
France, I'm afraid you've only got 14 points. 14 points. I'm sorry, we have a little trouble with our scoreboard there. Thank you very much indeed, Monaco. Now, let's go to Hilversum and say good evening, Netherlands. Could we have your votes, please?
Good evening, Angela. Here are the results of the Dutch jury. First of all, we think that Holland has 6 points up till now, not 5 points.
You've given our jurors a problem here,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, we are counting here.
You're counting, so are they.
I'm sorry. Shall we go on with our votes?
Look, why don't we let them sort out their problems?
Okay.
You give us your votes, okay?
All right.
Okay.
Ireland, 1 point.
Ireland, 1 point. Irlande, 1 point.
Germany, 3 points.
Germany, 3 points. Allemagne, 3 points.
Portugal, 2 points.
Portugal, 2 points. Portugal, 2 points.
United Kingdom, 7 points.
The United Kingdom, 7 points. Royaume-Uni, 7 points.
Greece, 10 points.
Greece, 10 points. La Grèce, 10 points.
Israel, 5 points.
Israel, 5 points. Israel, 5 points.
Spain, 6 points.
Spain, 6 points. L'Espagne, 6 points.
Finland, 4 points.
Finland, 4 points. Finland, 4 points.
Belgium, 12 points.
Belgium, 12 points. Belgique, 12 points.
They're the favorites.
France, 8 points. 8 points.
France, 8 points. France, 8 points.
And that completes the points of the Dutch jury.
Thank you very much, Angela.
Bye-bye.
Thanks very much indeed. Well, I'm glad whatever it is happening to the French score, they're winning at the moment because they're out ahead with 22 points. We've got Greece with 20, Israel and the United Kingdom both on 19. A couple of countries still yet to score, but I'm sure all that will change before we go much further. Now, we are going to Austria, to Vienna. Good evening, Vienna. Could we have your votes, please?
Bonsoir, Wembley. Ici Vienne. Voici les résultats du jury autrichien. Irlande, 5 points.
Irlande, 5 points. Ireland, 5 points.
Monaco, 8 points.
Monaco, 8 points. Monaco, 8 points.
Allemagne, 2 points.
Could you say that again for me, please? Allemagne.
Allemagne, 2 points.
Allemagne, 7 points.
2 points. 2 points.
2 points. Allemagne, 2 points. Germany, 2 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points. The United Kingdom, 12 points. Grèce, 4 points. Greece, 4 points.
Israël, 3 points.
Israël, 3 points. Israël, 3 points. Can we just wait while the score goes up on the board? Okay, go ahead, please.
Suisse, 10 points.
Suisse, 10 points. Switzerland, 10 points.
Espagne, 1 point.
Espagne, 1 point. Spain, 1 point.
Finlande, 6 points.
Finlande, 10 points. Finland,
6 points.
I'm afraid I'm having trouble with my deaf aid down here. Finland, 6 points. Finland, 6 points.
France, 7 points.
France, 7 points. France, 7 points.
Et ceci termine le point attribué par le jury autrichien. Merci, bonsoir.
Thank you very much indeed. How are we doing now? Well, Britain is out there in front with 31 points, which will please the home team. Now let's go to Norway. Good evening, Oslo. Could we have your votes, please?
Good evening, Wembley. Oslo calling. Here are the results of the Norwegian jury. Ireland, 12 points.
Ireland, 12 points. Irlande, 12 points.
Monaco, 1 point.
Monaco, 1 point. Monaco, 1 point.
Austria, 2 points.
Austria, 2 points. Autriche, 2 points.
United Kingdom, 7 points.
United Kingdom, 7 points. Royaume-Uni, 7 points.
Greece, 4 points.
Greece, 4 points. Grèce, 4 points.
Israel, 5 points.
Israel, 5 points. Israel, 5 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
Switzerland, 10 points. La Suisse, 10 points.
Finland, 8 points.
Finland, 8 points. Finland, 8 points.
Belgium, 6 points.
Belgium, 6 points. Belgique, 6 points.
France, 3 points.
France, 3 points. France, 3 points.
And that completes the voting of the Norwegian jury. Good evening,
Wembley. Thank you very much indeed, Oslo. Well, now let's go to Frankfurt and say good evening, Germany. Could we have your votes, please?
Hello, Wembley. Frankfurt calling. And here now the voting of the German jury. Ireland, 5 points.
Ireland, 5 points. Irlande, 5 points.
Monaco, 6 points.
Monaco, 6 points. Monaco, 6 points.
Portugal, 1 point.
Portugal, 1 point. Portugal, 1 point.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
Greece, 4 points.
Greece, 4 points. La Grèce, 4 points.
Sweden, 2 points.
Sweden, welcome Sweden, 2 points. Suède, 2 points.
Spain, 7 points.
Spain, 7 points. Espagne, 7 points.
Italy, 3 points.
Italy, 3 points. Italy, 3 points.
Belgium, 8 points.
Belgium, 8 points. Belgique, 8 points.
And France, 12 points.
I'm sorry, would you repeat that, France? France had?
12 points.
12 points. France, 12 points.
And that completes the points of the German jury. Thank you all and good night.
And thank you, Frankfurt. Good night. Well, Britain's still out there in front with 48, but creeping up now, France with 44, Greece with 32, and Norway still to score yet. Now, let's go to Luxembourg. Bonsoir, Luxembourg. Votre vote, s'il vous plaît.
Oui, bonsoir, Angela. Voici les résultats de vote du jury luxembourgeois. Irlande, 8 points.
Irlande, 8 points. Ireland, 8 points.
Monaco, 1 point.
Monaco, 1 point. Monaco, 1 point.
Norvège, 3 points.
Norvège, 3 points. Norway, 3 points, making their first appearance on the board.
Allemagne, 2 points.
Allemagne, 2 points. Germany, 2 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points. United Kingdom, 12 points.
Grèce, 6 points.
Grèce, 6 points. Greece, 6 points.
Suisse, 5 points.
Suisse, 5 points. Switzerland, 5 points. Can we just wait while it goes up on the board? There it is. Go ahead now, please.
Okay. Espagne, 7 points.
Espagne, 7 points. Spain, 7 points.
Belgique, 4 points.
Belgique, 4 points. Belgium, 4 points.
France, 10 points.
France, 10 points. France, 6 votes.
10 points, 10 votes.
10 points, 10 points.
Et cela termine le vote du jury luxembourgeois. Bonsoir, Angela.
Thank you very much indeed, Luxembourg.
Thank you.
Britain still out in front, 60 points. France with 54. It could all change, of course. Lisbon, let's call you. Lisbon, are you there, please, Portugal?
Yes. Good evening, Wembley. Here is Lisbon, Portugal.
Could you speak a little louder, please, Lisbon?
Yes.
That's
These
better.
These are the results of the Portuguese jury. Ireland, 1 point.
Ireland, 1 point. Irlande, 1 point.
Monaco, 6 points.
Monaco, 6 points. Monaco, 6 points.
Norway, 2 points.
Norway, 2 points. Norvège, 2 points.
Germany, 8 points.
Germany, 8 points. Allemagne, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 12 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points. United Kingdom, 12 points.
Greece, 10 points.
Greece, 10 points. Grèce, 10 points.
Switzerland, 4 points.
Switzerland, 4 points. La Suisse, 4 points.
Italy, 3 points.
Italy, 3 points. Italy, 3 points.
Belgium, 7 points.
Belgium, 7 points. Belgique, 7 points.
And France, 5 points.
And France, 5 points. La France, 5 points.
That completes the voting of the Portuguese jury. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Lisbon. United Kingdom, 72 points.
Well, it's your turn now, United Kingdom, to vote, and I shouldn't have any trouble hearing you because you're only down the road in Television Centre. Come in, United Kingdom, can we have your votes, please?
Hello, Angela, very good evening to you. Television Centre, London calling, indeed. Here are the results of the United Kingdom jury. Ireland, 12 points.
Ireland, 12 points. Irlande, 12 points.
Monaco, 7 points.
Monaco, 7 points. Monaco, 7 points.
Netherlands, 1 point.
Netherlands, 1 point. Les Pays-Bas, 1 point.
Norway, 2 points.
Norway, 2 points. Norvège, 2 points.
Germany, 8 points.
Germany, 8 points. Allemagne, 8 points.
Greece, 5 points.
Greece, 5 points. La Grèce, 5 points.
Switzerland, 4 points.
Switzerland, 4 points. La Suisse, 4 points.
Spain, 3 points.
Spain, 3 points. Espagne, 3 points.
Belgium...
I'm sorry, can we...
Can we just
can
hold on 1 second? I think we're having a bit of trouble with the scoreboard again. Greece, they're saying. What's wrong with Greece?
Greece should be 53.
53. We've got 48. That's it. Okay, I think we stopped you at Spain, was it?
Shall I repeat it again in case?
Yes,
Spain,
please.
3 points.
Spain, 3 points. Espagne, 3 points.
Belgium, 10 points.
Belgium, 10 points. Belgique, 10 points.
And finally, France, 6 points.
France, 6 points. France, 6 points.
And that, Angela, completes the points of the United Kingdom jury. Good night to you.
Good night, and thank you.
And I'm sorry, we have still a mistake on the scoreboard. For Netherlands, it should be 7.
Oh, yes, they must have all the points they can get. 7, yes, 7 points. United Kingdom, 72 points. France, 65. It's getting very close down there at the bottom of the board. Okay, let's go over to another favourite. Greece, Athens, could we have your votes, please?
Hello, Wembley, this is Athens. Here are the results of the Greek jury. Ireland, 10 points.
Ireland, 10 points. Irlande, 10 points.
Monaco, 12 points.
Monaco, 12 points. Monaco, 12 points.
Netherlands, 2 points.
Netherlands, 2 points. Pays-Bas, 2 points.
Austria, 4 points.
Austria, 4 points. Autriche, 4 points.
Germany, 8 points.
Germany, 8 points. Allemagne, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 1 point.
United Kingdom, 1 point. Royaume-Uni, 1 point.
Switzerland, 6 points.
Switzerland, 6 points. La Suisse, 6 points.
Spain, 4 points.
Spain, 4 points. Espagne, 4 points.
Finland, 3 points.
Finland, could you repeat your vote, please?
Finland, 3 points.
3 points. Finland, 3 points.
Belgium, 5 points.
Belgium, 5 points. Belgique, 5 points.
France, 7 points.
France, 7 points. La France, 7 points.
And that completes the points of the great good night.
Good night, Athens. Thank you very much indeed. You've made it a really close match for us. United Kingdom, 73. France, 72. And we're just over halfway through the judging. Israel, now let us say good evening, Jerusalem. Could we have your votes, please?
Hello, Wembley. Jerusalem calling. Here are the results of the Israeli jury. Ireland, 12 points.
Ireland, 12 points. Irlande, 12 points.
Monaco, 2 points.
Monaco, 2 points. Monaco, 2 points.
Netherlands, 1 point.
Netherlands, 1 point. Les Pays-Bas, 1 point.
Germany, 5 points.
Germany, 5 points. Allemagne, 5 points.
United Kingdom,
yes,
8 points.
Royaume-Uni, 8 points. United Kingdom, 8 points.
Greece, 3 points.
Greece, 3 points. La Grèce, 3
points.
Finland, 7 points.
Finland, 7 points. Finland, 7 points.
Belgium, 6 points.
Belgium, 6 points. Belgique, 6 points.
France, 10 points.
France, 10 points. La France, 10 points.
And this completes the voting from Jerusalem, Israel. Good night.
Good night, Israel. Thank you very much indeed. And what's happened to our scoring?
I'm sorry.
We've got a problem again. That's what's happened
to us. Yes, I'm afraid I have to interrupt you. You didn't give a vote of 4 points to anybody, Israel.
Israel, are you still with us?
Yes, I'm still with you. Switzerland was, yes, maybe I skipped it. Switzerland, 4 points.
Switzerland,
thank you very much.
4 points. La Suisse, 4 points. Thank you very much indeed, Jerusalem. And as I say, you've altered the order of the voting for us because France is now in the lead by 1 point, 82 points. The United Kingdom, 81. My goodness, it is a really close race at the top there. What about Ireland at 74? So catching up. Good evening now, Switzerland. Could we have your votes, please?
Bonsoir, Wembley. Ici Berne. Voici les résultats du vote du jury suisse. Irlande, 8 points.
Irlande, 8 points. Ireland, 8 points.
Monaco, 6 points.
Monaco, 6 points. Monaco, 6 points.
Pays-Bas, 7 points.
Pays-Bas, 7 points. The Netherlands, 7 points.
Portugal, 4 points.
Portugal, 4 points. Portugal, 4 votes.
Grèce, 1 point.
Grèce, 1 point. Greece, 1 point.
Israël, 10 points.
Israël, 10 points. Israël, 10 points.
Espagne, 3 points.
Espagne, 3 points. Spain, 3 points.
Italie, 2 points.
Italie, 2 points. Italie, 2 points.
Finlande, 5 points.
Finlande, 5 points. Finland, 5 points.
Et France, 12 points.
Et France, 12 points. France, 12 points.
Et ceci termine le vote du jury suisse.
Thank
Bonsoir
you very
à
much
à
indeed. Bonsoir, Suisse. Well, the order's changing around a bit down there. France, 94, United Kingdom, 81, and Ireland now in second place with 82. I tell you, I'd rather be out here than in the back where all the artists are. It must be terrible in there at the moment. Now let's go across to Stockholm, Sweden.
This is Stockholm, Sweden. Good afternoon, Wembley.
Good evening. Could we have your votes, please?
Yes. Ireland, 12 points.
12 points. Irlande, 12 points.
Monaco, 10 points.
Monaco, 10 points. Monaco, 10 points.
Norway, 1 point.
Norway, 1 point. Norvège, 1 point.
Germany, 5.
Germany, 5 points. Allemagne, 5 points.
United Kingdom, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 8 points. Royaume-Uni, 8 points.
Greece, 7.
Greece, 7 points. Grèce, 7 points.
Israel, 3.
Israel, 3 points. Israel, 3 points.
Finland, 2 points.
Finland, 2 points. Finland, 2 points.
Belgium, 4 points.
Belgium, 4 points. Belgique, 4 points.
And finally, France, 6 points.
France, 6 points. La France, 6 points.
That's all from Stockholm. Good evening.
Thank you, Stockholm. Good night. Well, France has made the 100. France now in the lead with 100 points. Then comes Ireland, 94. Then the United Kingdom with 89. It's all between those three at the moment. Let's see now what happens when we go to Madrid and say, bonsoir, Madrid. Could we have your votes, please?
Hello, Wembley. It's c'est Madrid. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir.
Voici les résultats du jury espagnol. Irlande, 4 points.
Irlande, 4 points. Ireland, 4 votes.
Monaco, 8 points.
Monaco, 8 points?
Oui.
Monaco, 8 points.
Pays-Bas, 1 point.
Pays-Bas, 1 point. The Netherlands, 1 point.
Allemagne, 5 points.
Allemagne, 5 points. Germany, 5 points.
Luxembourg, 7 points.
Luxembourg, 7 points. Luxembourg, 7 points.
Royaume-Uni, 3 points.
Royaume-Uni, 3 points. The United Kingdom, 3 points.
Grèce, 12 points.
Grèce, 12 points. Greece, 12 points.
Israël, 6 points.
Israël, 6 points. Israël, 6 points.
Italie, 2 points.
Italie, 2 points. Italie, 2 points.
Et France, 10 points.
Et France, 10 points. France, 10 points.
Et ceci termine les points attribués par le jury espagnol. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir, Madrid. Thank you very much indeed. France still out in front with 110. Ireland now in second place with 98. Now, good evening, Rome. Could we have the votes of the Italy jury, please?
Hello, Wembley. Ici Rome. Voici les résultats du jury italien. Irlande, 8 points.
Irlande, 8 points. Ireland, 8 points.
Monaco, 12 points.
Monaco, 12 points. Monaco, 12 points.
Norvège, 5 points.
Norvège, 5 points. Norway, 5 points.
Allemagne, 6 points.
Allemagne, 6 points. Germany, 6 points.
Portugal, 3 points.
Portugal, 3 points. Portugal, 3 votes.
Royaume-Uni, 2 points.
Royaume-Uni, 2 points. The United Kingdom, 2 points.
Grèce, 1 point.
Grèce, 1 point. Greece, 1 point.
Suisse, 4 points.
Suisse, 4 points. Switzerland, 4 points.
Espagne, 7 points.
Espagne, 7 points. Spain, 7 points.
France, 10 points.
And France, 10 points. France, 10 points.
Ceci termine le point attribué par le jury italien. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir, Rome. Thank you very much indeed. Well, they're still out in front with 120. Ireland now catching up on 106. Britain, 94. Let's see what Helsinki will do to the scoring. Good evening, Finland. Could we have your votes, please?
Good evening, Wembley. This is Helsinki. I have here the results of the Finnish jury. Monaco, 5 points.
Monaco, 5 points. Monaco, 5 points.
Austria, 1 point.
Austria, 1 point. Autriche, 1 point.
Luxembourg, 8 points.
Luxembourg, 8 points. Luxembourg, un moment s'il vous plaît, Luxembourg, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 4 points.
United Kingdom, 4 points. Royaume-Uni, 4 points.
Greece, 6 points.
Greece, 6 points. La Grèce, 6 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
La Suisse, 10 points. Switzerland, 10 points.
Spain, 7 points.
Spain, 7 points. Espagne, 7 points.
Italy, 2 points.
Italy, 2 points. Italie, 2 points.
Belgium, 3 points.
Belgium, 3 points. Belgique, 3 points.
And last, but by no means least, France, 12 points.
France, 12 points. La France, 12 points, which has put them still way out in the lead with 132. Well, there are only two more judges that we have to call up. Belgium, Would you like to give us your votes, please? Bonsoir, Bruxelles.
Bonsoir, Wembley. Ici Bruxelles. Voici les résultats du jury belge. Irlande, 3 points.
Irlande, 3 points. Ireland, 3 votes.
Monaco, 2 points.
Monaco, 2 points. Monaco, 2 points.
Les Pays-Bas, 10 points.
Les Pays-Bas, 10 points. The Netherlands, 10 points.
La Norvège, 5 points.
La Norvège, 5 points. Norway, 5 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points. The United Kingdom, 12 points.
Grèce, 6 points.
Grèce, 6 points. Greece, 6 points.
Israël, 1 point.
Israël, 1 point. Israël, 1 point.
La Suisse, 8 points.
La Suisse, 8 points. Switzerland, 8 points. Do you have
Espagne, 7 points.
Espagne, 7 points. Spain, 7 points.
France, 4 points.
France, 4 points. France, 4 votes.
Ceci termine les points attribués par le jury belge. Bonsoir, Wemby.
Bonsoir. Thank you very much indeed. Well, what a position to be in. We have one jury to call up. That jury is France, and at the moment, France is way out in front with 136. Paris, it's all up to you. Could we have your votes, please?
Allô, Wembley, ici Paris. Voici les résultats du jury français. Irlande, 10 points.
Irlande, 10 points. Ireland, 10 points.
Monaco, 5 points.
Monaco, 5 points. Monaco, 5 points.
Pays-Bas, 8 points.
Pays-Bas, 8 points. The Netherlands, 8 points.
Autriche, 1 point.
Autriche, 1 point. Austria, 1 point.
Allemagne, 2 points.
Allemagne, 2 points. Germany, 2 points.
Portugal, 6 points.
Portugal, 6 points. Portugal, 6 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Grèce, 3 points.
Grèce, 3 points. Greece, 3 points.
Israël, 3 points.
Israël, 3 points. Israël, 3 points.
Italie, 7 points.
Italie, 7 points. Italy, 7 points.
Finlande, 4 points.
Finlande, 4 points. Finland, 4 points.
Belgique, 1 point.
Belgique, 1 point. Belgium, 1 point.
Et ceci termine les points attribués par le jury français. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir, Paris. As one of our juries said, last but by no means least, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Eurovision Song Contest for 1977 is France. To present the Grand Prix for the Eurovision Song Contest for 1977, may I present the President of the European Broadcasting Union and the Director General of the BBC, Sir Charles Curran. Good evening, Sir Charles. To receive the Writers Award are the composers of L'Oiseau, L'Enfant, Joe Gracie and Jean-Paul Carat. That's what winning does for you. Well done. Thank you. And to receive her award, Marie Myriam. Marie Myriam, I think she's celebrating behind with all the other artists. Can you hear us, Marie? Is she with us? I can imagine the scene backstage now. Someone rushing to find the winning artist. Where is she? Has someone bought her a bottle of champagne? Is that what it is? Feet running up the stairs. Along the back. There she is. And so the Grand Prix has been won by France. Would you like to go and sing? The nice thing about winning is you get to sing it again. Ladies and gentlemen, of course we congratulate the winner of this year's Eurovision Song Contest, the 22nd. The winner is France, and so of course we must ask Marie Myriam to perform for us once again, L'Oiseau L'Enfant. Before she does so, may I thank all of you, the hundreds and millions of you that have joined us this evening. We can't see you, but we thank you for being with us. Ladies and gentlemen, from London, from all of us here, and especially from the winners, good night.
Aux yeux de lumière qui voit passer au loin les oiseaux, comme l'oiseau bleu survolant la terre, voit comme le monde est beau. Beau le bateau dansant sur les vagues, ivre de vie, d'amour et de vent. Belle la chanson naissante des vagues, abandonnée au sable blanc. Le sang du poète qui en chantant invente l'amour pour que la vie s'habille de fête et que la nuit se change en jour, jour d'une vie où l'ombre se lève pour réveiller la ville aux yeux lourds, où les matins effeuillent les rêves pour nous donner un monde à passer au loin les oiseaux comme l'oiseau.